Hello and welcome. Today we are going to deal with Physiographic Division of India. Now, India's physical features influence a lot of our life. Let's see how. Now, if you're new to this channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you get all my future classes. Let's get into this class. India has different physical features such as mountain plains and plateaus. I want you to understand two theories. First one is continental drift theory and second one is plate tectonic theory. Now, continental drift theory was introduced or proposed by Alfred Wegener in 1912. Now, according to him, in the past, all the continents were as one and mega oceans surrounding it. The supercontinent was called as Pangaea and the mega oceans surrounding it was called as Penthalassa. So this is what happened. Around 200 million years ago, the mega continent started to split. Now this continent was broken into two parts, Eurasia and Gondwanaland. The northern part was Eurasia and southern part was Gondwanaland. Over time, they started to split into more parts and this was called as continental drift theory. Let's see the second one. The second one, plate tectonic theory. This was introduced by or this was proposed by Parker and Morgan in 1967. According to them, tectonic plate is a solid massive rock consisting of both lithospheric and oceanic crust. They believe that there were seven major and seven minor plates. The seven major ones were African, North American, South American, Eurasian, Australian, Antarctic and Pacific plates. And the minor one which also exists are Arabian, Nazca and Philippine plates. Let's know more about this. Now, tectonic plates are of two types, thicker continental and thin oceanic. The difference between the strength and density between upper lithosphere and lower asthenosphere. What is asthenosphere? Basically, the upper layer of the Earth's mantle below the lithosphere allows the tectonic plates to move. And then other natural forces such as gravity and Earth's rotation also contribute to the movement of the tectonic plates. The plates are constantly moving in different directions and at different speed. Some of them move from 2 centimeters to 10 centimeters per year. Let's look at the next part, that is plate boundaries. The place where two plates meet is called as plate boundary. The place where two plates meet each other are called as plate boundary. There are basically three types: conversion, diversion, and transform boundaries. I'll try to make it as easy as possible. Imagine this is one place and this is another plate. We put them side by each other. The place where two plates where come towards each other, crash into each other, are called as conversion plate boundaries. This process has led to Himalayan mountains and Great Northern Plains. Second one is divergent plate boundaries. When the two plates move away from each other, are called as divergent plate boundaries. And because of this process, Narmada Valley was formed. Third one is transform boundaries. Let's have a look at this. When two plates just slide past each other, are called as transform boundaries. The two famous examples of these are Sant Andres and California. Let's talk about the continental drift theory and India. India and an ancient shallow sea called the Sea of Tethys were on a tectonic plate. Now, it began to move northwards about 90 million years ago during the Cretaceous period at the speed of 15 centimeters per year. What is Cretaceous period? This was about 145 and 65 million years ago. It was pretty long time back. So,
The plate started to move at a speed of 15 centimeters per year.
Now 15 centimeters is only that much. That's all it was moving. The tight oceanic crust was in the Asian continent. The plates were welded together, they were joined together to form a high plateau of Tibet and the Himalayan mountains. Let's understand the formation of India. And finally, for today, let's look at the last part, formation of India. The great arc of mountains consisting of Himalayas, Hind Kush, Patkai ranges defines it as the northern Indian subcontinent. Now these mountain ranges act as a natural barriers to the cold polar winds, and it also isolates India from rest of Asia. And due to India's location, India has developed a tropical monsoon climate. That's it for today. If these classes are helping you, don't forget to hit the like button and leave a comment. Now, in the next class, we'll talk about the northern plains, the northern mountains, coastal plains, and much more things. See you next time. Take care. Thank you very much.